This year's prize is about rewriting the code of life. The code of life. The Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences has today decided to award the 2020 Nobel Prize in Chemistry jointly to Emmanuelle Charpentier and Jennifer Doudna for the development of a method for genome editing.
I'm so honored to introduce this year's Nobel Prize in Chemistry. It's a fantastic prize. Many have been waiting for it. And it's two amazing laureates. To explain their discovery, I will take you from the big scale, things we can see, to the smallest pieces of life that are invisible to our eyes. A human being, like me, is made up of trillions of cells, and thus each cell is tiny, tiny. In each cell, we have our genetic material, the DNA. DNA is long and thin, like a piece of string. That's built up of building blocks called bases. The DNA in each cell contains about 6 billion of bases placed along this string in a particular order. This is what we call the code of life. From this code, thousands of proteins are made in every cell that then perform all kinds of functions in our bodies. So this year's laureates, Emmanuelle Charpentier and Jennifer Doudna, have developed an elegant system named CRISPR-Cas9, or simply genetic scissors, that can cut the DNA string at one and only one selected position among all the billions of bases. The ability to cut the DNA where you want has revolutionized the life sciences. We can now easily edit genomes as desired, something that before was hard or even impossible. Today, CRISPR-Cas9 is a common tool in biochemistry and molecular biology labs. It's also used in plant breeding and for novel treatments of human diseases. The genetic scissors were discovered just 8 years ago, but have already benefited humankind greatly. Only imagination sets the limits for where this chemical tool, that's too small to be visible with our eyes, can be used for in the future. Perhaps the dream of curing genetic diseases will come true. Thank you.
The pandemic puts constraints also on the further Nobel Prize celebrations. So we are not requesting that the Nobel laureates come to Stockholm in December to pick up their prizes. Instead, we plan for digital Nobel lectures and a digital Nobel Prize ceremony with laureates participating over video links. We are still working on these events, together with the Nobel Foundation and now, from now on, also with the laureates themselves. And we will come back to you with details as soon as possible. But I can guarantee you that Drs. Charpentier and Doudna will receive their awards before the end of the year and that they will be our guests of honor next time we can celebrate Nobel Week with the traditional festivities here in Stockholm.